I have created the ultimate Windows PC troubleshooting tool, an AI with access to over 3 million words of documentation for Windows, and you can use it for free. What the heck am I talking about? Well, you may have heard that ChatGPT, a while ago, they introduced a feature called GPTs, custom GPTs, where you could basically give it custom instructions, provide it with a bunch of documentation, documents that it could search through. And I made a tweet about this, but at the time, these custom GPTs were only accessible to customers, ChatGPT Plus subscribers, and it was like 20 bucks a month. So I didn't really make a video about it. However, very recently, this has changed, and ChatGPT now has access to these GPTs with a free account. So you can go in the description, I'll show you how this all works, and it's very cool. The link directly to the one I made is in the description, and when you go to it, don't worry if it says requires ChatGPT Plus. I don't think they updated that yet. It does not, as you'll see. So I can just sign in with Google, like my TheoJoke Test Google account, and then that does not have ChatGPT Plus, so you'll see what you'll see. And if it happens to not bring mine up immediately, you can go to Explore GPTs on the left and then search for what it's called, which is Windows Troubleshooter and with docs reference. And you can make sure it's the one by TheoJoe.com. And it just has this icon that says unofficial. I'm not trying to, you know, trick anyone. This is definitely not official, so don't think this is official in any capacity. Though it does reference a lot of actual documents from Microsoft's website, but still, don't think this is gonna like necessarily give you very good advice all the time. Anyway, you can ask it basically anything. For example, what is this Windows event error log that I can just copy and paste, and it'll answer you. And it's a little bit better than what regular ChatGPT will do, because it should theoretically, if it follows my instructions, actually search through all of its knowledge and documents that I provide it, and hopefully that will make it more likely to be correct. Now, I would be cautious if it gives you any commands to run, maybe double check that, Google what it does first, because it is still ChatGPT on the back end, so it's not perfect. I wouldn't really trust it with just blindly running commands and stuff. It's more of like a guiding thing to give you an idea of what could be wrong, that sort of thing. And if you're wondering about just exactly what documentation I provided it, we can look at that, because even though there's 3 million words, I counted, yes, from all the documents combined, that's actually just the tip of the iceberg for all the possible documentation that Microsoft has out there. I had to be a bit selective, as you'll see. Before that though, something else that's also unfortunately out there is all your personal data, which is where today's sponsor comes in, Aura. Sketchy data brokers out there collect and sell your information to scammers, spammers, and anyone else who may want to target you. I'm talking about your full name, email, home address, health records, your relatives' info, it's all out there. But that's where Aura comes in. For example, it can show me which data brokers are selling my info and automatically submit opt-out requests for me. Cleaning up this info not only helps me reduce the amount of spam coming my way, but also protects me from hackers who might leverage this info to try and access my accounts or even do personalized phishing attacks. I was even surprised when it showed me that the collected public info out there even included what kind of car I drive. But Aura also has a ton of other features, such as an antivirus, a VPN, password management, parental controls, identity theft insurance, all in one place, instead of needing a bunch of separate apps. Even if you already have one or two of these tools, you could still be leaving the doors open to bad actors. But Aura is always on, so you can have peace of mind and focus on the other important stuff. To get started, you can go to aura.com/theojo to start your 2-week free trial, and the link is also in the description. And with all that being said, let's continue. All right, so let me take you behind the scenes and you can see how I actually set this whole thing up so you can get a better idea of how it works. Now, to be clear, to make a custom GPT like this, you do need a ChatGPT Plus subscription, but you don't need one to use it. So you can use this one that I made for free. These are all the files I uploaded to it. I think you can have up to 20 files and they can be up to like 500 megabytes, although there is a text amount length limit. So I think it's like 2 million tokens. That ends up being like a few million characters. So it's not like you could just upload hundreds of megabytes of pure text files. I did try, believe me. I'll show you more of these in detail later. Just realize that it's not like ChatGPT has all of this text and knowledge in mind immediately. It's not like it's in its context window. It still has to search through it. So it's possible that it will miss stuff, but assuming that it does a search, however it searches through stuff, it should be able to find stuff more likely than just having its general training data. Anyway, so as part of the knowledge it's provided, I uploaded 4 ebooks to it. So these are official Microsoft ebooks. The first two is Windows Internals Part 1 and 2. So this has a lot of really technical stuff and all about Windows 10 mostly, because that's when it came out, but it still applies to Windows 11. And this is actually a really cool ebook or physical book that you can get. I do actually recommend you get it if you're a computer nerd like me, or to just look through stuff if you're trying to troubleshoot yourself anyway. I also provided it to other ebooks. One is Windows PowerShell Step by Step, and the other one is Troubleshooting with Sysinternals, which is like the Sysinternals suite, another thing I've talked about before, very useful. And just to be clear, no, you can't just ask it to give you the download link for all its knowledge. I turned off the code interpreter feature that would let you do that because I don't really want to get hit with copyright infringement. So it will be able to search through stuff and reference it, but it's not like it's going to be able to just print out the entire book for you. Then in addition to the ebooks, there's a whole crap load of documentation that I downloaded from Microsoft's site. These are like publicly available because if you didn't know, on Microsoft's Learn pages, all their support articles, they have a new feature, relatively new, that's actually very cool. If you go to the bottom left, you'll see an option to download PDF on most of them, and it will let you download a PDF version of basically an entire category. So not just that specific article you're looking at. And for some of these, it's like thousands of pages of article all in one you could just download. So I did that for a whole bunch of categories of documentation and also converted those to text as well. One example is a huge topic, all the articles under Windows security. And this, as you can see, is nearly 2,000 pages long alone. And that is one of the reference files it has. It also has documentation from the topic of Windows client configuration. That's over 700 pages. Windows client troubleshooting, nearly 2,000 pages. Desktop Win32 app documentation, over 500 pages. And then I converted it just to plain text to be a bit more compact. Then I also went to all the articles that listed all the Windows system error codes, copied all those, put them in a text file and provided it that as well. But I wasn't really satisfied with that. I wanted more because there were some topics that were more general that I couldn't find a direct PDF download that they had on their site. But I knew that there was another way, which is because Microsoft actually has all their documentation, all these articles actually exist on GitHub as public repositories, if you didn't know this, as markdown files. So they actually have a whole account just called Microsoft Docs. And in that account, there's thousands of different repositories of different types of documentation. And within each of those, there might be thousands or even tens of thousands of articles. So yeah, there's a lot of it. Anyway, what I was able to do is go into the different repositories where they had articles about certain subjects, for example, the PowerShell one. I simply downloaded that entire repository, got all the markdown files, the MD files, those are like the article contents. And then I have a little script that combines them all into one file. And then I converted it to plain text and cleaned it up a bit. So I did that for a number of topics, just took all the possible articles and combined them into one, uploaded it. So like I said, I did that for the PowerShell docs, PowerShell 5.1 specifically, that's the version that's built into Windows. I also did it for the articles for Sysinternals and Windows Terminal, and then all the articles in the Windows client subdirectory in the support articles repo. Now, if you're wondering why I didn't just download literally every single possible article and give it all to ChatGPT, I definitely would have liked to do that, but there's more than you might realize. For example, within just one of the repositories, the Win32 docs repo, which is one of the bigger ones to be fair, that one alone has over 50,000 articles, and I did try to combine them all. It ended up being a text file that was over like 200 megabytes and like 200 million characters. And yeah, that was a lot more than ChatGPT was willing to let me upload. So for a lot of those big giant repositories, I kind of had to be selective and get some of the more subtopics, like ones having to do with configuration, that sort of thing, what I thought was most relevant. Because most of the stuff anyway is like enterprise stuff that most people don't need to know about, and it's kind of irrelevant. So it's not a huge deal anyway. So after uploading all of it with this documentation, then there's the instructions part where you actually like tell it how to work. It's actually kind of funny what I had to do at the end to get it to make sure it always looks at the documentation. We can take a look at that in a second. But basically, it just tells it that it's a specialized assistant for troubleshooting Windows and researching features. It can draw on the knowledge from these different ebooks. It says, explain it in clear, easy to understand, blah, 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 from beginners to experienced users. I also tell it to avoid speculation and stick to well-documented information, though of course you still have to always double check, obviously. And I'll probably tweak it a little bit because I do tell it that it should ask for clarification when necessary, although these AIs tend to be a little bit overconfident. They basically never ask questions. Then I give it the actual titles of the different documentation files that it's given. And then next, this final part is actually kind of funny. For context, the new ChatGPT-O model that OpenAI uses for everything, including these. It is supposedly smarter, but it kind of has trouble following instructions. Like, if it gets on its own track, it's hard to get it off a track. So, for example, if it starts making a mistake and you tell it, don't do that again, a lot of times it'll do it again. And one of the problems I had with this GPT and other custom GPTs was that even though I would give it a bunch of documentation and tell it to look at the documentation, it wouldn't. It would just immediately start replying, and I could see that it never said searching knowledge. So it was really annoying because it's like, look at the documentation I gave it. That's why I gave it to you. So I realized you have to be extremely heavy-handed with telling it to use the documentation, like to an absurd degree. Anyway, I created this whole thing at the bottom, and you can copy this if you want. I found it does work pretty well at getting it to actually look at it. I put this whole section, it says, important and essential, you must always reference your provided knowledge documents, even if the user does not specifically ask you to, exclamation mark. It is entirely the point of it being there, and you have proven unreliable when you do not reference it. You have been given those many documents, and you must search through it when providing any answer, including follow-up questions. Because another thing was, it might search for it the first time, then when you keep asking, it would just not search more. And I say, to be clear, do not send any message without first referencing your knowledge. You must search your knowledge, even if you think you already know the answer. It doesn't matter, always look through your provided reference knowledge documents. And believe it or not, even with that, it still sometimes would not look at the documentation, so I added this bottom part, which is just ridiculous, I know, but it works. And I just made this up, by the way. It's all BS. This is not like an actual protocol or anything. I say start instruction section, priority, maximum, infinite, mission critical. I repeat again, search your knowledge documents before every answer. Every answer, every single answer. The documents are what you need to search. End instruction section. And yes, these ridiculous instructions do seem to actually get it to follow and look at the documentation. It should say search and documentation every time. So, kind of funny behind the scenes. So I definitely would be curious to know how well this works for you guys, especially with the new GPT-4o model, which is supposedly better, maybe better with my instructions. If you guys do find this useful and helpful, maybe in the future I'll make even more videos about new ones that I can make about other stuff, not just Windows troubleshooting, but other software. Again, just don't take every word this thing says as gospel. It's still AI on the back end. It's not like a genius or anything. It's more of like a good guide, but not like super intelligent necessarily yet. So yeah, let me know all that down in the comments. We can talk about it down there. Thanks again to Aura for sponsoring. If you want to protect your data and take advantage of all the other features it has, go to aura.com/theojo for a 2-week free trial. Link is also in the description. So if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about a new Windows security feature in the new upcoming Windows 24 H2 update that you might be interested in. I thought it was cool. I'll put a link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.